press record. Okay, so we're going to just start jogging on the spot. We just got ourselves to warmed up. Okay, so we're just jogging on the spot. Just starting to warm up that body. I don't know how many of you guys were there on Monday for our session with Denise, but I really enjoyed that. I thought that was good. So next Monday, we have another lady coming. Ashling is her name. So we're going to come to the end of our mat wrap, do our walkouts. So she's going to come and do a CrossFit session with us. So you're going to come into that low lunge and open. So she sent me her plan today, and it looks so good. So that's on Monday. But I'll send you the details for that anyway. So if you want to join, you can. It'll be at 6 o'clock until 6:40. Good. Oh, I'm feeling very stiff today. Good. Let's do two more of these. So all the way out. Make sure those wrists are just underneath the shoulders. And when we're walking back, we really want to keep those hips nice and high. Stretch out those hamstrings. And other side. Okay, we're standing up. We're going to do 6 jumping jacks. So 6 of these. 6 high knees. 6 bone kicks. So we have 6 jumping jacks. Nice and quick. 6 high knees. And 6 bone kicks. Good. Nice big circle, nice, not circles with your arms, but big stretch up overhead. Just loosening up that upper body, especially if you have been sitting at your desk or even on the sofa. Good, we'll do one more there. Good, big high knees. Really try to engage that core and bump it. Okay, we're going to go into some squats. So you can decide. So we're going to do like a normal width squat. So we're really trying to keep that chest up. Or you can go a little bit wider into that kind of sumo position squat. So once you have that, you decide what width you want to go. When you come down, I want you to do a little pulse and stand. So little pulse and stand. Good. So now you're going to pulse, and when you stand, I want you to come up onto those tippy toes and down. So we're warming up our hips. We're warming up kind of that in, like our groin area. And we're also warming up our calves. So try to kind of hold that balance for a second and then come back down. Let's do 4 more. 3, 2, 1. Okay, down onto our mats. We're gonna do dead bug. So we've done these once before. So we're onto our back. Knees are up at 90 degrees. Hands are up over our chest. If our left leg comes down towards the ground, our right arm comes down as well. Back to center. So right leg, left arm, back to center. And you're trying to keep that lower back pushed into the mat. So we're engaging that core. Push that lower back into the mat. And you'll feel those abs start to turn on. Let's do 4, 3, 2, 1. Perfect. Staying on the ground, we're going to do our glute bridge. So make sure those heels are quite nice in towards our bum. Lift those hips and lower. So So those heels are staying on the ground. Our knees are pointed forwards. They're not caving in. You can keep those hands on the ground for a little bit extra support. And really squeeze your glutes at the top. So we're trying to warm up. They're big muscles. We're trying to warm them up as well as our hamstrings, those big muscles at the back of our legs. Let's do 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Now let's take a moment to stand there. I have a conditioner in my hair and I'm definitely gonna get it all over the mat. That's okay. Okay, so we are going into 4 upper body exercises. Exercise number 1, we're gonna come into our push-up. I'm gonna show you on our toes first. So we're going push-up, sit back into those heels. So you're gonna bend those knees, sit back into our plank. Too difficult, onto our knees, push up, then into our plank, and sit back. And likewise, if this one is too much, bring those knees in. So we're in like a box position. Lower that chest towards the ground, into our plank, and sit back. Okay, right, 40 seconds. You ready? I am obsessed with this song. I cannot stop listening to it. Okay, you ready? 40 seconds, 3, 2, 1, let's go. So, aiming towards our chest to the ground. It is better for you to get fewer repetitions with a good quality rep than this. We don't want this. We want down towards the ground and push up. Take your time. You are only here once. Give it everything. 2, 1, and relax. We only have push-ups today. All you want. Okay. Flipping around. Fingers pointing towards your toes. We are lifting. Push those elbows back behind us and lift. Literally tiny movement. You got 3 seconds. You ready? So lifting those hips. Elbows coming towards behind us, so straight behind us. And we're lifting up. So if I don't, you can see here. That's literally how tiny the movement is. We're working the back of those arms. If you have a chair or a table and you want to do tricep dips off that, you crazy person, you go do that. You got 15 seconds. All the weight is in those hands. So it's not your hips lifting, the back of those arms, those triceps are doing all the work. And rocks. Okay, coming onto the ground. We are in a W position. We are lifting and lowering. Hands into a T position. Lift, lower. I position, lift, lower. So W, lift, T, lift, I, lift, W. T, I. So we're working that upper back. Good. Keep breathing. You're only lifting as far as you can, so don't strain that back. Small movement. You have 3 seconds. And relax. Last exercise here. We're going into a plank and you're going to do shoulder taps. I mean, this is kind of more abs than arms, but look. So we're going to be in plank, shoulder taps. If that's too difficult, come into a half plank, shoulder taps. Okay, let's give it a go. So you are trying to keep those hips level to the ground. So I don't want to see this. We're trying to stop that rocking, strong body. The only thing moving are those hands. You're barely tipping that shoulder and coming back down. Pull that belly button in, strong foundation. We're working those abs. We're working those arms. Keep going. You got 5 seconds. And then upper body is done. Done and dusted. Woo! Okay.
Right. Relax. Take a drink of water if you need to. I'm going to reset my timer. Okay, we're going into lower body next. So you have 5 exercises.
You are going to do all 5 of them on one side, and then we're going to go on to the other side. So exercise 1, we're standing. You're going to reverse lunge back, but you see this front leg, it's a little bit bent. So usually we're here, we reverse lunge back. This is our usual position. What I want you to do is bend, small movement. So all the tension is staying on that front leg, okay? That's exercise 1.
Let's go with that first. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Let's go. So we have a little bit of a bend, small step back, okay? Good. You can do whatever you want with your hands. I always kind of hold them in front of me because it kind of helps with balance. This leg is gonna be sore. The full foot is on the ground, so make sure that heel is on the ground. Make sure that those toes of the front leg. So that front leg is doing all of the work. Keep that bend, you got 3 seconds. I know it's burning. And relax, good. Okay, that leg is staying in front. So in my case, it's my left leg. I'm gonna do a curtsy lunge. So instead of going straight behind me, it's like I'm doing a curtsy and I'm standing. So now I'm gonna add a little pulse and stand. A little pulse and stand. Okay, let's give that a go. So the leg that you were just working is the one that's staying still. So in my case, my left leg isn't moving. That's the one that I'm really trying to tire out. I feel sore already. And we've only done 2 exercises of the 5. But you're only doing this circuit once, okay? So really try to give it everything. You won't be here again. Keep that chest up. Oh my God, my bum. 2. And relax. Okay, give it a shake. Then we come onto our mat. So that leg is going to bend in, other leg is out. We're going to lift and lower. Lift and lower. You ready? Right, let's go. So the leg is doing the work on the ground, the other leg is lifted. You can cross it over if you want, or up in the air. Good. So drive that heel into the ground. All the work is doing is being done on one side of the body. 10 seconds. Lift. Squeeze that glute at the top. And relax. Good. Okay. Onto all 4s. Now, that same leg is coming straight out behind us. We are going to lift it and we are going to do small circles. Okay? You got 5 seconds. You ready? 3, 2. So, lift that leg, but doing the work. Small circles in one direction. Okay. You're going to stay in that direction for another 10 seconds, and then we're going to go the other direction. Small movement. Okay, opposite direction. Nice flat back. Keep going. I know it's burning. You have 10 seconds. Keep the leg lifted. Small circles. You got 3, 2, 1. Okay, you got 1 exercise left here. So we are on all 4s. We're coming out to the side and down. So lift that knee, and lower. Okay, 5 seconds. You ready? Let's go. So lift, lower. This is what you came for. So you're coming at it like a 90 degree angle. We are really isolating. Isolating those glute muscles. And you do all 5 of these on our other side. Keep breathing. You've got a 90 degree angle. Up and down. 10 seconds. Good. You are nearly there. Last 5. And relax. Okay, we are standing. So I'm doing all of the other side there. So we got those lunges to begin with. Okay. 5 seconds. So remember, loose knee. Which leg am I going? Oh no, other leg. Yeah. So small, it's like a mini reverse lunge. Okay. So you got a little bit of a bent knee, like a loose knee for that foot that's in front. You're barely touching the ground and then you're pushing back in. Make sure that back is nice and straight though. So we don't want to be rounded. Strong foundation. You have less than 10 seconds. My legs are on fire. 3, 2, and relax. Good. Okay. Let's shake that out. We're coming into that curtsy lunge with our little pulse, and we are standing. 10 seconds. Get your breath. You're only doing these once. You're over halfway through your workout already. You ready? 3, 2, let's go. Good. So chest up, nice and tall. Pushing this heel, the leg that's doing the work, push that heel into the ground. Drive up, nice and strong. Good. Any of these are too much, get rid of that pulse. So you can literally just come into our regular curtsy, or you can change the exercise entirely. Just try to keep moving as best you can. You have 3 seconds. And relax. Good. Okay. Single leg bridge. Okay. You got 10 seconds. Leg that's doing the work is on the ground. The other leg is straight or crossed over the leg doing the work. Are you ready? Let's go. So up in the air. Or it's crossed over your leg. Whatever is more comfortable for you. Squeeze your glutes at the top of the movement. So lift those hips as high as they can go without kind of straining that lower back. So drive into that heel. You have less than 10 seconds. Keep it going. I know it's hard. And relax. Good. That's definitely my least favorite. So, onto all fours. We have that leg going straight behind us. Small circles. Ready? You have 5 seconds. Your legs are like spasming here. We ready? Up we go. So small circles in one direction. Good. So either point your toe or have the heel up to the ceiling. Whichever you prefer. Okay, opposite direction. Again, strong back, strong foundation. Small movements. Less than 10 seconds, we got those fire hydrants, and then our leg work is done. We are on to abs then for our final 6 minutes. Whew. Okay, fire hydrants. That knee is coming out to the side, 90 degree angle. We got 5 seconds. So we're really isolating this side of our glutes, whichever side you're working. I'm working my right, out to the side, and down. Drive that knee up. Good. You are so close to the end. Keep going, all the way. Had such a small movement with no weight can cause so much pain. That's it, you got 10 seconds. Good. All the way until you hear that buzzer. And relax, good. Okay. Take a sip of water if you need to. And then we are going on to our ab session. So let me just set this up. So we have 6 exercises. We are going to work for 40 seconds, 20 seconds rest. Okay, we ready? We are going to come down onto our mat and we are going to do a high to low plank, which is particularly brutal. So we're having hands underneath our shoulders, nice strong position, down onto our elbows, back up. Try to alternate the hands that you're coming up and down on. If this is just too much, try to keep it going for as long as you can, and then you just hold plank, okay? Right, 40 seconds, let's go. Hands underneath our shoulders, low to high. Good. You take your own pace with this. Go faster than me, go slower than me, but find your rhythm and keep it going. You are only here once. That's it. You have 7 seconds. Good. I know your arms are starting to tire. And relax. Okay. We are coming onto a forearm plank. So those elbows underneath our shoulders. We are going to rotate left to the middle, to the right, to the middle. So it's like our hands and our feet are stuck and we're rotating our body left to right. That's it. So we're working those sides. They're called our obliques. Make sure that you come into the centers so that you can really keep a nice strong position. Flat back. Draw that belly button in. I always keep my feet quite close together so I can kind of swivel. You have 5 seconds. And relax, good. Okay, we are coming into a slow mountain climber. But what I want you to do is, those knees are gonna come really out to the side. So rather than coming into the center, out to the side. We ready? Okay, so into our plank. This is the pace. Slow. That's it. You are over halfway. For anyone who is there on Monday for Pilates, oh, my stomach. You're over halfway though of your entire ab session. So stay with me. Oh, that's tough. Okay, relax. So we are coming into a side plank. We are only gonna be here for 30 seconds. So you're gonna put that hand underneath our shoulder or your elbow. Ooh. Sorry guys, okay. So hand, you can go a half plank in this position. You can go full plank. If you want to, You come down onto that elbow, whichever you prefer. Okay, quickly, let's swap on the other side. Good. Again, if you need to, come into that half plank, that's perfect. I know our shoulders are probably quite sore now as well. You've got two exercises left. And relax. Okay, we are going to come onto our back. We are doing either full sit-ups. So we're going to sit up all the way and give me two punches, or we're doing small crunches. You decide. You've got 3 seconds. Are you ready? So small crunches, or we're coming all the way up, two punches at the top, all the way up, two punches. Whatever you want to do, you pick. You've got 30 seconds. You have one more exercise after this and you're done. Good. Dig deep now, okay? You've got 15 seconds. As many repetitions as you can get. Do not slow down. Try to pick up the pace for these last 7 seconds. How many can you get? Keep going. Push and relax. Good. Okay, last exercise. You're doing 6 mountain climbers into a jump. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Jump in. Back you go. Brutal. I'm sorry. Last exercise though. 3 seconds. You ready? 6 mountain climbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Jump in and back. Give it everything now, okay? You have 25 seconds on the clock. Once you hear that buzzer, your workout is done. As fast as you can go. You don't want to feel like you have anything left in the tank at the end of this workout. You are here only for you. So give it everything. You have 3 seconds. And relax.
Good job. Ooh, looking nice and red. And relax. Okay. Take a breather. Try not to sit down. Walk it out. Quick cool down. And we are done. Okay. We gotta bring down that heart rate. On to all fours. Okay, our cat cow. Curl that back up. Stretch our belly down. Have a little bit of a wiggle here. You did a lot of core work, okay? So stretch out those muscles. You keep going there. Let me just lower this in. Okay, so keep going. Let's do another couple. Cat-cow. Sorry, I'm just gonna. Okay. So, big rounded back. And just breathe. Chill out. Okay. Let's bring our right leg in front. What I want you to do is lean forward into that leg, okay? So you should have feel a big stretch on the front of that leg that's behind us. Keep the back straight though. So as I said, nice, good, solid foundation. Don't just dump your weight forward. Try to keep your integrity in your body. And then I want you to pull that leg back. So you're aiming chest towards your knee. That's good. If you need to have a little bit of a bend in that leg to help you get down there. Good. Okay, let's swap. So again, nice strong foundation. Push our hips forward, keeping that kind of railroad or rail line kind of tracks, train tracks, I should say. Good. Don't strain our lower back. So you're just really trying to feel that stretch on our groin, the front of that back leg. And then let's pull back.
what's good. And again, like, have a little shimmy here if you need to. I always feel like I can feel the stretch a little bit more if I kind of wiggle around. So rather than just doing exactly what I'm doing, try to listen to your body. See if there's something else that you need to stretch out. That's totally okay. As I said, this is your workout. You know, you gotta do what you want to do and what feels good for your body. So we're gonna come up into our downward dog. So we're gonna lift our hips up into the sky. And if we can, we're just gonna pedal those feet behind us. So bend one knee, straighten this, bend this. Good. Hang that head. Again, left to right, yes and no. Good. And last one, down onto our mat, onto your knees, or you can sit cross-legged, whatever is more comfortable. Good. I think it's really important as well to know that sometimes you're just not going to be feeling it. Sometimes you've shown up for the workout, but you're tired, or your mind is elsewhere, or your body just needs to rest, and that's okay. So sometimes if you can smash out 10 burpees or 10 push-ups, and then one day you're just not able to do it, that doesn't mean that you're not progressing. That means you just have to listen to your body. And sometimes it's actually easier to force our bodies to do things than actually listen to it and just slow down. So don't ever feel like if I've given an exercise to make it a little bit easier, that you're like, you know, that you want to try to push to do the hard one. You just have to listen to your body that day, and, you know, that's okay. That's all right. I do that all the time. Okay, guys, that is us done.